how to share two-factor with another person. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question that I often get. I get two-factor, and I'd use it, except that my wife and I both sign into a shared account, and we each have our own phone. If the 2FA were on my phone, wouldn't she have to ask me every time a code was needed? That's a pain. Yeah, that is a pain. The good news here, of course, is that there's a very good chance that that pain is not necessary. If you can use a specific type of two-factor authentication, then you can set up both of your phones as allowed two-factor devices for the same account. The type of two-factor authentication we want to use for this is the TOTP two-factor. TOTP stands for Time-Based One-Time Password, which I often refer to as Google Authenticator compatible two-factor authentication, or just Authenticator-based. Once it's set up, your device, typically, but not always, your smartphone, displays a 6-digit code that changes every 30 seconds. It's your ability to present the current code correctly when requested that acts as your second factor. Unlike most other forms of two-factor authentication, we can set up TOTP on more than one device. Now, if you don't have a smartphone or a device that can do this, or the service you're using doesn't offer TOTP authenticator as a second factor, then this style of option just isn't going to be available to you. But if you can, and it is pretty common, then yes, absolutely, we can remove this annoyance for you. The process is actually pretty straightforward. Let me show you here in my example Google account. I'm going to go to managing my Google account. Over in security, we'll go ahead and scroll down. So you can see in this account, I have several different forms of authentication available to me, but I don't have the two-factor authentication device. That's the authenticator. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to add more sign-in options. We'll click on that. We have to re-verify my password, of course. Set up the authenticator. Now, this will talk, of course, about the Google Authenticator app because this is a Google account and they're going to talk about Google things. There are a lot of compatible apps, Google Authenticator compatible apps. So don't feel that you necessarily need to install that specific app. If you don't have an app, it's a fine one to use. But if you have another app that already does this kind of two-factor authentication, there's a pretty good chance you can use that too. We'll click on Setup Authenticator. So here we have a QR code. What am I going to do? I'm going to screenshot it. Whatever tool you happen to use is fine. I happen to be using the built-in Windows screenshot tool. I will, in this case, switch to a window and have it automatically select, well, it's selecting the entire browser window. The alternative is to select a rectangle and then just select the specific QR code. Once it's in the snipping tool, you can then mark up and share, or more importantly, you can save that code to a file in a secure location. Now, if for some reason you don't have a device that has a camera that can use this QR code, well, that's what the CAT scan it is all about. That then will give you a text string that you can save and enter manually. Now, in my approach, I actually save both of these because it's not just about setting up the QR code now. But once you've done so, once you have set up this QR code with one device, you can then use the screenshot or this saved text string to then go and set it up on a second device. So again, to run through the list real quickly, we signed into the account that we wanted to share with someone else, in this case, my example account. During the process of setting up the authenticator-based two-factor authentication, we took a screenshot of the QR code, or we copied this text code that's still on the screen. Of course, you use that QR code to set up the authenticator on the first device. But then, honestly, at any time in the future, you can use that QR code that you saved a second time to set up the authenticator on a second device. It's actually kind of cool because when you do that, both of the authenticators on these two different devices will actually be showing the exact same six-digit number at the same time. Each device should now act as an accepted two-factor authentication for that account. Like I said, the trick is just this. That QR code contains all of the magic. By saving that QR code, you can set up multiple two-factor authentication devices for the same account at any time. Should you ever lose your device, it's also a great way to set up two-factor on a replacement without needing to do the traditional thing of turning two-factor off and then back on again to set up a new relationship. Save the QR code in a secure place in case you need it later. All right, there's another approach, and honestly, while I do what I just described, I save the QR code and I save the text string, I actually use something else. Now, I'm going to go back here to where it's showing me that QR code again, because you'll notice that it is one password has been sitting in the background and is offering to save the QR code for me. If I do this for this account, which actually turns out to be this one, in this case, I have selected the account that I'm working with, and I'll hit save. So, what just happened? 1Password did something. Well, if I go take a look at the entry for this account, you'll notice that this account has now saved both, of course, the username and password, but there's a one-time password present. This is the one-time code that is associated with this QR code. And if I now hit next and enter the six-digit code you see in the app, well, in 1Password for this account, that's this number. So if I just copy it, paste it, and verify, I now have two-factor authentication set up for this account. Why did I just show you all that? Well, it's a password manager. You can sign into your password manager on multiple different devices. For example, I just did this on my PC, but that password manager is also installed on my phone. So the two-factor code that I just set up for this account is now available on both my PC and my phone. In fact, since I have 1Password installed on multiple PCs, this is an example PC you're looking at. It's also on my real PC. It's also on my laptop in the other room. I can provide the second factor code from any of those devices. And if your password manager can share items or collections with another user of that same password manager, then accounts with two-factor authentication can also be shared, and it will include the second factor. So I do both of these things. For example, my wife and I share a certain online shopping account, which has two-factor authentication enabled. The information is stored in 1Password. So when a two-factor code is needed, I can use any of my PCs or my mobile phone to provide the second factor code. Since that item is shared between my wife's 1Password account and my own, either of us can provide the code. It's probably the most convenient way to manage two-factor on a shared account. Now, for completeness, I want to include at least one other scenario. It's less common, but it can sometimes be another way to share two-factor across multiple devices. My bank, for example, has a dedicated banking app. And when I sign in to my banking account, it offers me a couple of different approaches to authenticating the second factor. As with so many banks, it's usually limited to SMS or maybe email. Google Authenticator or TOTP is for some reason not one of the options. However, one of the options is to respond to a notification on another device that you're already signed into, specifically the app for that bank. So, The approach to sharing this second factor is simply to make sure that the bank's app is installed on both my phone and my wife's phone, that they've both been signed in at some point in the past to establish the relationship to the account. And then when I sign in on some new device to the banking account, I simply say, I will respond to a notification in the app. Then that notification shows up, actually on both of our phones, and one of us simply needs to say, yep, that's me. Poof. We're both able to respond to the second factor simply because we both have the associated app for that website installed on our devices. Like I said, it's not as common, but it's happening. I know it's there for my bank. It's probably there for your Microsoft account if you're using a Microsoft Authenticator. I think there's some scenarios where Google will do it as well, but it is one other approach that you might investigate. So, yes, enable two-factor authentication on all the accounts that support it. It's one of the most important steps you can take to secure your account. If you can, use Authenticator-based two-factor authentication, saving that QR code or the text code as you set it up. You can then share that code with anyone else you'd want to allow access to the account. And if you're both using a password manager which supports TOTP two-factor, even better. The two-factor capability is just included when you share it with someone else. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/182150. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.